Xinjiang Daqo New Energy is a leading manufacturer of polysilicon for global photovoltaic industry. It announced a record production and net profit in the third quarter of 2021. It is one of five companies sanctioned by the U.S. Department of Commerce in June, accused of using forced Uyghur labor. But the company's staff records suggest otherwise. None of the ethnic minority employees at Daqo are Uyghur or Kazakh.
By July, average monthly income in the company was about 7,600 yuan. The average for minority employees was 12,000 yuan. There are relatively few minority staff, and many of them work at mid-level positions in the company, so they tend to earn more.
After going public this year, the company says it plans to issue shares to mid-level managers, including engineers, to retain employees. In 10 years, I've risen from an ordinary staff to a deputy director of the machine maintenance workshop. The company gives us plenty of space for promotion, as long as you have the ability.
Production technology has also improved rapidly. The U.S. sanctioned companies say they have now mastered the production of electronics-grade polysilicon. It requires a much higher level of purity than photovoltaic grade, and can be used for semiconductor devices and circuits.
We are planning a project to produce 1,000 tons of electronics-grade polysilicon. We've completed the recruitment and technical aspect, and site selection is underway. If all goes well, we will be producing electronics-grade polysilicon in 2 years.
China now supplies more than 70% of the global polysilicon market.
Daqo says the U.S. makes up a relatively small part of its sales revenue.
And as for raw materials, the world's largest manufacturer of silicon metal also says it mainly focuses on the domestic market. Supply and demand are both booming, and so Chinese silicon producers report little short-term impact from the U.S. sanctions. But there are potential threats.
Silicon metal is used in many industries. If there is a crackdown on products made by export enterprises that we supply, the knock-on impact will be greater.
Some see U.S. sanctions against silicon makers in Xinjiang as a long-term threat to the world supply chain and worry about the potential for future efforts to contain Chinese technological development through decoupling.
Once your polysilicon manufacturing technology is mature in terms of advanced equipment and quality control, it's easier to move into production of electronics-grade silicon. Some countries are already suppressing on Chinese chip technology and lithography. Western countries don't want to treat us as equals in making electronics-grade polysilicon.
Silicon producers in Xinjiang say the best response to the trade ban is to improve their competitiveness. And with China aiming to achieve carbon neutrality, industry insiders see more opportunities in the domestic circulation than worries from foreign sanctions. Feng Yilei, CGTN, Shihezi in Xinjiang.